Good morning. My name is Dr. James Kelly. I'm a family physician at the Olmsted office of Ohio Medical Group, period. I'm going to talk today about the flu, go over some of the basic points I think everyone needs to know. First, the flu is known as influenza. It's a very contagious disease. It's caused by the influenza virus. It can be spread by coughing, sneezing, or nasal secretions. The germs are spread when an infected person coughs, sneezes, or speaks. They can also be spread, the virus, by touching surfaces such as door handles, cups, silverware, things that we all use in our daily lives. Adults are contagious, which means that they have the possibility of infecting other people actually about a day before they actually get the symptoms. So they can be at the office or wherever and can be sick and not know that they're sick. Children may be contagious for a little bit longer. We're unsure of that. The symptoms usually start, which is what you feel, about 1 to 5 days after exposure to the virus if multiple factors such as your immune system, etc., predisposes you to getting sick with it. The risk increases with crowded places such as shopping malls, students in schools, children, daycare centers, nursing homes. If somebody's had a recent illness of any sort, if their immune system is decreased because of physical, mental, emotional stresses in their life, this decreases their immune system and predisposes them to potentially getting the flu virus and the symptoms. People with chronic illnesses such as kidney disease, heart disease, diabetes, HIV infection also are at an increased risk of contracting the flu. Preventative measures are as simple as never at any time, whether during flu season or other, putting your hands to your mouth, your nose, your eyes. This is one of the transmissions. It's very simple. We all do it, especially when we're tired. But this is something we really have to force ourselves not to do. Also, not drinking excessive amounts of alcohol, not getting yourself physically or emotionally tired, getting your sleep, getting your rest, going to bed, turning the TV off. All of this does help our immune system. Some of the symptoms can be fever, chills, cough, sore throat, headache, muscle aches, fatigue, runny or stuffy nose. But these are not specific to the flu. Many other diseases can look or present like this. So in that context, somebody has to use good judgment to see within a day or two how they feel, and do they feel that their immune system and their rest, et cetera, and some of the treatments we'll talk about, conservative treatments, have worked. If not, they might consider seeing their physician. Most people that contract the flu, it is self-limited. They have an immune system and other that will have them be able to get over it. They should get extra fluids, whether that's Gatorade, water, soup, etc. You do not want to drink things with caffeine in any form. Teas, coffees, colas, things that have caffeine will actually cause you to lose fluid, even though they are fluids. You get a diuresis, a diuretic effect, and actually work against us. So conservative things, water being the basic thing that we all need, is one of the best substance to help out. If you have nasal congestion, you can make a simple nasal nose drops yourself, or you can purchase them at the store. A quarter teaspoon of salt in about 4 ounces of warm water, shaken into a glass, preferably plastic if you're in the bathroom in case you drop it, you don't want to shatter. And inhaling it through the nose and then exhaling can clear the nasal passages of some of the secretions or mucus and does help some of the symptoms. Cool mist humidifiers does increase air moisture in smaller or limited rooms. They work very well. Wash your hands often if you're sick, using common sense in terms of door handles, flushers on the toilet, things that you don't want to inoculate for other family members or loved ones to contract. Warm heating pads for aching muscles are good as long as you don't fall asleep and cause indirect burns of the skin. Acetaminophen, which is known as Tylenol,
In adults, aspirin can be used. Aspirin is not indicated for children or people under the age of 18 due to the possibility of Rye syndrome, which has been associated with certain viral infections in aspirin. Cough syrups, nasal sprays, nasal decongestants may be used. Any viral drugs are not over-the-counter, meaning you cannot buy them in a store. You have to go to a physician. One of the ways, outside of what we discussed, to prevent or minimize the effect of getting the flu is to get an influenza or the flu vaccine. Those people that are in close contact with many people, such as teachers, police officers, firemen, doctors, nurses, people that work in malls, and also grandparents who are around grandchildren, or parents who are around children, are at risk not only for themselves, but that they would inadvertently contract the disease and pass it to somebody of a young age, which could be lethal to the child. So grandparents, parents are definitely around small children, should get the flu vaccine for not only their safety, but for the bigger picture of the home situation. Again, any questions that you have, feel free to ask your physician. No question is silly. They're all good questions, and thank you.